say my remarks.
That's structured.
So the people that are right.
Some days we would be out on what is called the turn road, so that we could begin to work. We also went to church a lot, and a lot of times nobody would be there but us. And I remember this one time that a brand new young pastor had just been assigned. And after about 30 minutes, nobody was there but my father and I and the pastor. So he looked out at my dad and said, "Well, Brother Davis, I see nobody's here but me and you and your son. What do you think I ought to do?" So my father said, "Son, let me tell you, since I am a farmer, I ain't no preacher." And he said, "When I get ready to feed my cows, I just go on down to the pasture where they are." And so the young preacher started. He had what we called a certain cadence that he used when he sang those. Then he had a general song that we all just kind of sang. Then he had a prayer, read the scripture. He did the glory patri. Then he took up an offering. Then he had another song. And he went ahead and gave his sermon. And then he took up a building fund. And he took up a general offering. Gave him an addiction. He looked at my dad and he said, "Well, Brother Davis, how did I do?" He said, "Well, son, like I told you, I am a farmer, I ain't no preacher." And he said, "It's true that when I get ready to feed my cows, I load the wagon full of hay and go on down to where they are." He said, "But son, it don't put two of them cows. I don't give them the whole damn wagon." I mean, I decided to do politics as a result of working for a community development organization called the Greater Lawndale Conservation Commission. And I also ended up there because I was teaching GED at the time, General Education Development, for people who didn't have high school diplomas, or people who were immigrants who had come from other places and wanted to be Americanized. And that's really how I ended up meeting these politicians in the community. And of course, part of the thing that we did last week, we talked of the money that we need. We cut out something called the New Market Tax Credits, a bill that I was one of the primary sponsors in the House when Bill Clinton was president, and it happened to be the last bill signed. And my congressional district has used millions and millions and millions and millions of New Market Tax Credit money to do redevelopment. I was out in Englewood the other day at a new shopping center on 63rd Street. They use New Market Tax Credits. The new structure down at Pulaski and
Washington
on the L track, Lake Street. All of that was done. A woman named Mary Nelson, who used to be the director. That is the politicians that make the decisions. Mm-hmm. And so you start at the lowest level and work up to the point of where the decisions get made. And they're not made on the basis of what is right and what is wrong. that I made on the basis of what is good and what is bad. They are made on the basis of whatever it is that is socially, economically, politically, and sometimes morally acceptable to whoever it is that has the power and the will to decide. I mean, there's so much wrong with the community that, you know, we could talk for 25 years about decisions that have not made sense or don't make sense, but we just have to keep pressing forward and try. As good as Westinghouse is, we need 5 more Westinghouses.
Transportation.